Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Confessions with Yoga the Biker. I am Yoga, and today we are doing an interview with
Lyric.
Okay. So, as I always get started, what is the reason you decided to start riding?
So I always loved watching people ride growing up, like even at the age of like 15, 16.
Okay.
But never actually got involved in it until I met my husband. My husband, he's been riding for a long time, and so he introduced me to actually getting involved in riding. He started teaching me like around the way, around our neighborhood.
Okay.
And then I finally took the Harley Davidson class in Lithonia.
Okay.
Lithia Springs, excuse me.
So you took the riding course?
Yeah.
And then went from there?
Yeah, in Lithia Springs, passed that, and the rest is history.
Okay, so how long have you been riding?
Wow, 3.5 years now.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah.
I would never have known that.
Yeah.
Okay, from there, did you do, because I know that you are a track rider, did you start on the track or where did you get started?
So I actually started in the street. I had no interest in the track at all.
Okay.
All I wanted to do was ride pretty much any scenic route possible.
Okay.
Eventually I got into mountain rides, but it was mainly just focusing on the street. I had no interest in track,
okay,
at all.
What are some scenic routes that you would suggest to us riders out here?
So I would definitely say if you're into the mountain rides, go to Chiaha Mountain. Phenomenal. It's beautiful out there. Really open. Some tight twisties, but then also some really nice sweepers. That's one of my favorites.
Okay.
I've done Blood Mountain. That's not my favorite, even though a lot of people in Georgia love Blood. Hey, it's cool.
Yeah.
Just not a favorite. But I would say that's one of my scenic routes that I would say I cherish and love the most.
Okay. So then you said you started riding street and everything.
Right.
So what made you decide to switch from riding to doing track riding then?
My husband again.
Okay. So. Good old second half.
Right. So he had gotten into track riding and loved it. And he kept telling me about, you know, all the benefits of track riding, which is really where you're able to just kind of open up, get really one-on-one with your bike, get familiarized with all the components of your bike. Without the distractions, without the police, without the potholes in the ground, without the drivers, you know, who are distracted and not paying attention. So part of that was really just getting involved in getting on the track and the benefits of it. So that's kind of what drove me to that. It was him. It was like putting it in my ears every day, all day.
Track ride.
I mean, so then once I finally did it, I fell in love. I mean, to be able to push your bike to the limits. And it's funny because when you're on the street, you know, you're blasting and you're having fun and you're thinking that what you're, you know, you're believing that, oh, I'm able to really just take it to the next level.
Yes.
When you get on the track, I would say the first time on the track, those corners come up so quick.
Okay.
You're live. Where's my brake now? You know, it just changes your dynamics and your mindset. I mean, I've seen people who have ridden the street for years and they get on the track and it's just two differences. And it doesn't make it better or worse. It's just a whole different level and different component of riding that challenges your thought process even quicker.
Okay.
That's kind of how I got into track riding.
Where was your first track day at?
It was at Road Atlanta.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, in Bradenton. Yeah. And I high-sided.
Oh, wow. And what is that for folks that don't know what that is?
Right. Okay. So high siding is when you actually go in the air over your handlebars. So low side is when you are actually, the bike lays down to one side or the other and you're sliding. So I actually went over the handlebars going into turn one.
Okay.
And so I pretty much hit a nice speed. And for me, I panicked, took too much brake, and there I went. It got real quiet. And all of a sudden, I was in the air and tumbling.
Not the quietness.
I don't hear anything.
What is going on?
What's up? Oh, am I supposed to be up here? No.
No, that is not the case.
Yeah. But luckily enough, I was around a lot of great riders, including my husband, a lot of people from Atlanta Motorcycle Riders, which is a bike group, who encouraged me to kind of get right back out there. My bike was really more cosmetic. Mm-hmm. They was able to kind of get it fixed and back up and running that day, and I was able to ride. So this way it wouldn't distract me from ever wanting to get back on the track or deter me from doing that. So.
Okay. So for a new rider that would like to transition from street riding to track riding, what I guess advice would you give them?
I would say get your gear. Mm-hmm. First thing I like to tell people is, you know, invest in your gear. Get that ready first. Get your bike ready first. And there's actually a checklist that you can go on a lot of forums. Sports Bike Track Time has a great forum where it lets you know there's a list of things to do, i.e. For novice riders, you want to make sure that you have your mirrors either pinned back or taken off. Novice riders, you can really just pin them back.
Okay.
You want to make sure that your headlight, your backlight is taped up. So really just prepping your bike, making sure that it's ready to go for the novice group.
Okay.
With track riding, the phenomenal thing is that there are classes. So for like the novice group, you're not only on the track, but you're actually getting instructional time. So you're learning, you know, what is a line? What is an apex? What are those components that you need to be able to ride efficiently out there? The other thing is that making sure not only is your bike prep, but mentally you're prepped. You know, are you looking at the track that you're going to go to? If you're going to go to Little Tally, which is one of the tracks that I recommend first starting out at.
Okay.
It's a flat track, but it still has... And it's a small track, about, a mile or a mile and a half. But at the same token, it's challenging because you're learning, again, how to maneuver through the track.
Okay.
So, you know, just again, looking at, going on YouTube, looking at some of the, I like to say look at the intermediate, well, not even intermediate, look at some of the advanced riders, just see the layout of the track. Look, you know, do some research on it. So you're mentally prepared and you're not going out there like, what is this layout? What does this look like? And then just go out and do it. A lot of people, I think they're so concerned with, I'm going to wreck. My bike is going to get messed up. Your bike is used to ride.
What? Get out of here.
You know, I mean, enjoy every component, you know. Don't limit yourself. If you are someone who is in the streets, there's nothing wrong with being in the streets. I don't pass judgment on any type of rider because at the end of the day, we all have what we love to do, which is ride. It doesn't matter mm-hmm. how you like to ride as long as you're enjoying what you like to do. But I also say challenge yourself to get outside of the box.
Yes.
You know, go to the mountains. Take it slow. Take it easy till you're more familiarized. Go to the track. Go to a good organization that's going to help you maneuver through your track days. Again, making sure you're getting the fundamentals in your novice group. So this way, the more and more you do track days, the more and more you're comfortable, the more and more you're able to just get out and ride. So yeah, that's what I would say to new track riders.
Okay. Well, to wrap up, as always, I always ask, what got you started riding? And my last question, as always, what advice would you give riders in general?
Ride your ride. I know that is very cliquish or cliche-ish, but it's so true. I think a lot of riders have a tendency to get out and they have this ego or thought process where they're consistently trying to keep up with the next person. You can never keep up with the next person, one, because you don't know what their skill level is, two, you don't know what mods they have on their bike, and three, again, their thought process may be completely different than yours. Learn your ride, ride your ride, enjoy your ride. So if I was going to say anything to a rider, that's what I would say, that's what I would leave off on.
Great advice. Most of my riders, they say that, ride your ride, and I totally agree. Don't override, don't try to compete with others, because your ride is going to be totally different than someone else's. So, as always, thank you so much for participating with us with Confessions of the Biker. Are there any people or social medias that you would like to shout out before we wrap up?
Sure. Shout out to Sportbike Track Time.
Okay.
I'm on the staff there. They're a phenomenal organization, so definitely check them out.
Okay.
Shout out to my husband, Kino, S1K. And shout out to Atlanta Motorcycle Riders. I'm one of the admins there, so check them out on Facebook. We do a lot of group rides to the mountains, as well as we do track meets. So.
All right. We will have that in the post inside of the video and below. So until next time, love, light, and positive vibes, everyone. We're out.